My name is Kelly Mahoney, and I'm a research meteorologist with NOAA at the Physical Sciences Lab in Boulder, Colorado.
What causes floods?
Well, there are a number of different types of floods, so we can talk about them kind of generally. What causes a flood? Probably we can safely say that too much water of any kind causes a flood, right? But you can also picture rivers flooding. You can picture streets flooding. You can picture beaches flooding. And so floods can be caused by different things. So when a river floods, it can be from the rain falling onto nearby areas and rushing into the river and causing it to swell and rise and spill out and cause a flood. It can also be when a lot of snow melts up in the mountains or upstream and rushes down and causes a flood in the river. But in general, river flooding is caused kind of on lower or slower and longer time steps, and they can last for days or weeks versus a flash flood, which is the kind of flood you think about when you get a thunderstorm. And these tend to be really short-lived and kind of the dramatic floods when you just have so much rain falling on some kind of surface, whether it's concrete or just grass or hard dirt, and the surface can't soak it up. And so all of the water ponds on the surface and you can get a flood collecting there. And then you also can have floods at the coast, right? So when you think about hurricanes making landfall, sometimes we see those huge areas of water just taking over entire towns and neighborhoods and communities. And that can be when the water builds up and kind of rushes inland, and that can be inland flooding. I will say there are also some kind of oddball things that can cause floods, things called sunny day floods, and that can just be from really high tides or even sea level rise in coastal places, or when a dam breaks. So in some rare cases, you can get a flood without much rainfall, but in general, it's from a lot of water that the ground can't quite soak up, and so we end up with a flood. In my job at NOAA, I get to study floods from a lot of different ways. A lot of what I study is how fast and how hard the precipitation can fall, but increasingly we're really interested in what happens when that water actually hits the surface and how we can better predict for weather forecasting, but also over climate time scale. So as our planet keeps warming, we keep having more and more extreme events. And so I study different models that can tell us how to better forecast and how to better prepare for future floods. And one of the things that we've been looking at recently too is how what we do on the ground, even in our own yards and our own communities, can impact the type of flooding or the intensity of the flooding that we have. So it's really interesting to start to consider how having green areas in our communities, like grassy areas that can soak up lots of water, even having green grass and vegetables and things on your roof, in parks, in different areas, can make it so that things flood around us less intensely. So what should you do if you ever find yourself in a flood and you find yourself surrounded by water? In general, you always want to move away from the water, and you can call for help if that's available to you. But flooding, hopefully it might not happen in the blink of an eye. So if you are aware and you have a way out, up or away, you should be able to keep yourself safe.